It's been 25 years since the Hubble launched and changed how we looked at space forever. But even though it's probably the most famous space telescope, there are 93 other ones out there. What? Hey there, space cadets. Trace here, scoping out the science for DNews. In 1610, Galileo took a telescope and pointed it at Jupiter, igniting a love for space that goes far beyond simple naked-eye stargazing. The ultimate in astral gazing is the space telescope, an imager not affected by the interference of stuff here on Earth like clouds, weather, particulates in the atmosphere, or light pollution of a nearby city. The most famous of which is probably the Hubble Space Telescope. The HST isn't the largest telescope up there, but it is versatile, capturing visible and ultraviolet light with a bit of infrared sensing. Hubble orbits 353 miles above the Earth and was designed to be serviced in space by astronauts, something no other space telescope has yet done, which is lucky since it famously needed to be fixed right after it was launched. Hubble's final servicing mission in 2009 should keep it running until 2020, but eventually it will die. So what then? Along comes the James Webb. The James Webb Space Telescope is Hubble's successor. Its mirror is 7 times larger than Hubble's. The total surface area is the size of a tennis court. But while it's the follow-up to the HST, it is not identical. It captures mainly infrared light, because its larger mirror is designed to look way farther into the universe. And the farther things get away, the more redshifted they are. Redshifting is the tendency for the light of distant objects to elongate or shift toward the redder end of the light spectrum. To look far away, we need an infrared telescope. The James Webb will also be even farther from Earth, orbiting at Lagrange point 2. A Lagrange point is a spot in space where the gravity from two bodies is balanced, like a gravitational parking spot. L2 is actually out past the moon. It's the perfect spot for a telescope, like Planck, which is already there. See, we're only looking at a tiny part of the picture with Webb and Hubble, infrared, ultraviolet, and visible light. We've got way shorter and way longer parts of the electromagnetic spectrum. Infrared is longer than visible light, and microwaves are longer than infrared. Microwave telescopes scan the microwaves coming out of stars, but more importantly, the bubble of microwave radiation, which exploded way back in the Big Bang. The European Space Agency's Planck satellite was launched in 2009 with the goal of imaging that bubble of cosmic microwave background radiation, which surrounds our entire universe. This bubble is 13.7 billion years old, and it can tell us a lot about the birth of our universe. The ESA says Planck is so advanced that it will take measurements which cannot be improved on with any future telescopes, which is kind of crazy. But that is not all for the long waves. In 2011, Specter R was launched by Russia to look at the last wider band of the EM spectrum, radio. The Specter R has a 10-meter radio telescope to observe the structure of galaxies, star formations, black holes, dark matter, and interstellar space, things that we can't pick up with the nearer visible spectrum. Because those waves are so long, the Specter R works with ground-based telescopes to pick up as much of the radio signals as possible. As far as shorter wave telescopes go, the Chandra X-ray Space Observatory was launched in 1999. It's been sucking in X-rays from the hottest things in the galaxy, literally. X-rays are absorbed by Earth's atmosphere, so Chandra uses 4 angled mirrors to look at X-rays from exploded stars, clusters of galaxies, and matter around black holes while it is up in orbit. Scientists are using this data to learn what happens around supernovae and the structure of the giant supermassive black hole at the center of the Milky Way galaxy. This thing is tight, but not as tight as gamma rays. The Fermi Gamma Ray Telescope was launched in 2008 to probe the upper edge of the electromagnetic spectrum. It's looking for gamma rays, the tiniest and most energetic of all light. Gamma radiation is put out by supermassive black hole systems, pulsars, and often makes up cosmic rays. Studying these emanations can teach us more about physics in the universe and give rise to new theories about how everything fits together. Gamma waves are super fast, often zooming by in a fraction of a second, so Fermi looks at 1/5 of the sky at any given moment, so it doesn't miss a single burst. There's a reason telescopes are everywhere on Earth and in space. They are like Earth's eyes and ears out there, pointing at the universe. It's beautiful, ain't it? If you want to look beautiful too, try Jack Threads. Jack Threads is the only place that you need to shop to find the best gear that won't break the bank. They have stylists on call to make shopping a no-brainer, plus tons of great brands to select from. You can get an additional 15% off their already pretty great prices by visiting jackthreads.com/dnews and entering a coupon code DNews. You can do that at checkout. If you do that, you're helping us make DNews, and you're looking good doing it. Which telescope type is your favorite? Radio, gamma? I mean, I'm pretty biased against visible since I can see it. You can tell me down in the comments, and thanks for watching DNews.